This year's talk is about context-aware configuration in context of AEM. Last year I had a talk on only the sling part of context-aware configuration. I do a quick look back on this as well, but mainly it's focused on how do we use it in AEM in our real-life projects. Yes, it's me. I'm done of a lot of development with AEM. I'm Sling committer and PMC member and working at Provision. Short look back, what is Sling context-aware configuration? I'll do it really short because a lot of is already published on this. Keep in mind, context-aware configuration is about configuration related to a certain subtree in your resource hierarchy. That means it's not system configuration, which is done by OSGI, but it's a configuration which is different, for example, for each site, for each tenant, for each region. And this may be a feature flag, enabling some features on one side and not on the other side, or domain names of the different sites, or whatever. This is context-aware configuration related to a specific content subtree. A short view how it's usable by default. You have here a content tree, for example, one subtree for your tenant, for region, and for site. And this is below content. Then you have the conf tree. The conf was introduced some AM releases ago to be a central place where all configuration is stored. And this is not only used, for example, for definition of editable templates, et cetera, but it's also the main and default entry point for context-aware configuration. And there you can also have a tree like brand, tenant, region, site. How your tree does look like is you can choose it, but often it's related to the tree in the content tree because it's then easy mappable. And to map from the content area, your content trees to the conf tree is done by setting Sling config ref attributes. And in this example, it's only an example, I've used three attributes on three levels, one for the site, one for the region, which includes all sites in this region, one for the tenant, which includes all sites in all regions of this tenant. And the configuration values are stored within the conf tree and maybe with different configuration names, et cetera, so the details. And if no configuration is in place below the conf tree, then there are certain fallbacks, for example, to a conf global tree, and then to an apps-conf and to a libs-conf tree. So you have the possibility to ship default values for your configurations with AM itself or for your whole instance, et cetera. And just to quick sum up the core features of Sling context-aware configuration, you can do singleton configurations, which is just a map. You can configuration collections, where you have a list of maps for each configuration name. Usually, you use a Java class to describe this configuration. It's the same approach as used by the latest feature in OSGI release 6, where you use an interface class to describe your types and names of your configuration and additional metadata. You have the possibility to use collection and property inheritance, so you do not need to duplicate your configuration values if they are the same for all tenants, for example. You have to switch it on. It's not on by default, but you can set special properties to switch it on. And you have a quite complex service provider interface to adapt the different parts of context-aware configuration to your needs of your project. More details on this, see this task talk from last year for Sling in general. Okay, what do you do if you want to use context-aware configuration in AM? First, it depends on which AM version you're using. If you're using 6.3, the current version, you're lucky because it's already included by default. But I recommend to update to the latest Sling context-aware bundles anyway, because there were some important updates and some bug fixes since the general availability of AM 6.3. But if you're using older versions like 6.1 or 6.2, it's also no problem. You just have to play all the bundles, including the API, SPI, and the implementation, and the Johnson JSON parser bundle. And then you can use it in this version as well without problems. Just for convenience, here are the bundle versions listed, which are currently the latest versions. And even in 6.3, where some of these bundles are already included, you can just update them to the latest version. They are fully backward compatible because we adhere to semantic versioning. If you deploy it in AMM older versions, you have to add a few OSGI configurations to configure Sling context-aware configuration to AAM. You don't have to write them down. There's a link, and we keep this page updated when new AAM versions are in place. So you know what to add to configuration. It's quite simple. In AAM 6.3, most configuration is included. Only this last one, this ignore properties with SQL prefix, it's not included, but you can add it as well. Okay, now you have context-aware configuration in Sling. What in AM? What can you do with it out of the box if you do nothing more than have the bundles in place in this configuration? You can of course use all features from Sling context-aware configuration, but some features are still missing, even in AM 6.3. You can read configuration from /conf, including using a special configuration node structure which was introduced by the AM conf manager some years ago, where all configuration is packaged in SQL page nodes below /conf. This is a bit has some advantages because it's easier to use with replication in AM, which always replicates a page with all content in it. So if you have configuration in this structure, which is used by AM by default, it's working out of the box. But if you write configuration back using the configuration management interface of CA config, then it falls back to the default Sling implementation using only unstructured nodes. So this is missing. You have the only possibility to declare your context. I have some extra slides on this, is using the Sling config-ref attribute property. And you have especially no GUI. You have no editor to edit the configuration. You can only do it in CXDLite or whatever way doing content packages, but you have no GUI for the editors or power users to edit the configuration. Even if you have such a GUI, you have no possibility to activate it to publish, except you're just doing activate tree or building AAM package, etc., and replicating like this, which is normally not accessible to the normal editors, but only to admins. In AAM, there is a tool included called AAM Configuration Browser, but despite its name, it cannot be used to browse configurations, but only to browse configuration folders. This was introduced to create new folders for the editable templates. For this, it works quite well, and you can set permissions on those folders, but you cannot view and not edit the configuration, custom configuration you use with Sling context-aware configuration. Perhaps this will edit later, I'm not sure, but currently, and this includes AM 6.3, it cannot be used for editing or viewing your real configuration values and lists, etc. And in case you have used AM Conf Manager in your application, it was introduced already in 6.1, but it was nearly unpublished, undocumented, but it was quite useful. In this case, in 6.3, it's still present, of course, but it's only a thin layer, a wrapper around Sling context-aware configuration. So if you have used it, it makes sense to migrate your applications to directly use the Sling context-aware configuration API. Yes, what can you do if you want to manage your configurations in AAM? Let's start with an editor for your configuration, which is very useful to have editors using the configuration and maintaining it. I've included, I want to introduce a tool from WCMO, open source project platform we at Provision are maintaining, which is published Apache license. And there we have included an editor, a graphical editor for context-aware configuration. And I will just show to you how it's working on my local instance. Just switching. Okay, it's a really short sample, a really small sample application with just a really small tree. And I have a root homepage, and this is my first configuration context at content adapt to CA config MEN. And from this, I want to edit the configuration. Go to edit, and now I have a list of all configuration names. This is an important concept in CA config. You can have any number of configuration names, which is a unique name, and each is asserted with a map or a collection of maps, a list of configurations. And now it lists all configurations already available where I've entered some data. I can go to this sample config, and it just lists the different properties which are defined as metadata. Behind this is a Java class, just showing it here, an interface class which defines these properties, a string parameter, integer parameter, Boolean parameter, etc. And this class has some metadata on it, like a human readable name and a description, and perhaps an ordering to have a reasonable ordering, and some more. And this is used to display this configuration editor to show the names and the descriptions when you click here, and of course the values that were entered. And you have different types are used for different widgets, a text field, a number field where you just can enter numbers, it shows a validation error if I enter anything else, a checkbox for Booleans, and you can even have special widgets like a path browser widget. You can configure it for a certain root path, for example, showing only paths from DEM, local aim assets paths, or you can put a special parameter to let it show only other pages from the same context, which may be the current site. So here I have a path browser only showing pages of my small example site, and then I can select this and it just enters the path browser. Or I can have arrays of strings or integers or whatever and can use it in combination. In my example, I have more than one context. I have a set of nested context. This is my first context at EN, and I've defined another context for subpage, and I have another config page. So in this case, I'm using the configuration still stored of course, below /conf, but where I put my editor page, it edits the configuration context that is defined for this page. So now I'm going to one deeper level, to another nested configuration, where I can show you some examples for inheritance. I'm now at a subpage, and I've defined it another context, and now I'm inheriting some values. For example, I'm inheriting this integer value, this Boolean value, and the string value I've overwritten. If I want to go back to the inherited value, I can just check here, OK, inherited again. And if I want to break inheritance here, I can check this out and put another number to it. And so I have full control over property inheritance. And in case I'm using configuration lists, like in this case, I have inherited two list entries, two collection configuration maps from the parent context, and I've added a third item only available in this context. And this works because I've enabled collection inheritance. If I'd uncheck this, then I have only a new list and do not inherit anything from my parent. And I can add a new item and give it a new name, item 9 or whatever, and yes, enter new values, and then I have another item in my collection. I can save it, and then it's saved. And if I have more configuration names, I can go to add, and then it lists all configuration names which are not already used, but are registered within the system, and then can add configuration for it as well. You can only edit configuration with this tool where some metadata is present in the system. For example, using such an annotated Java class and deployed with your OSGI bundles. It's currently not possible to edit other configuration data because then the editor does not know what properties are available with what data types. But for usage in your application, it's exactly what you need. Yes, coming back, those are the features. You can edit singleton and configuration collections. You can edit all data types supported by CA config with a specific widget, number, string, array, whatever. You can control the collection and property inheritance, and you can have custom widgets like a path browser. Currently, only this is supported. There's currently work on providing also support for a rich text editor, for example, but it's not ready yet. And here again, where do you place these pages? The configuration is always stored below conf by default, but the configuration page you put there where you want to edit the context. With this, you do not need a complex configuration context browser in your editor. You just place it for the author where you on the author side where you want to edit the configuration, and you edit the configuration of the configuration context. In this case, for example, content my site. This sling config ref defines the context at this place, and therefore the config editor here edits the configuration for content my site, which is mapped to conf my site. And this is the configuration name. Another point, context pass strategies. The question is, you have a very big content tree, perhaps for a lot of tenants and a lot of sites, and you have to define where do your context start and where does it end. And by default, as you've also seen, you do this by placing the sling config ref properties on every site, on every new context you want to define. This, of course, can get quite tedious and probably error-prone if you have really a lot of sites, for example, 1,000 sites in your AM instance or even more. And if you have so big number of sites, you have usually a good convention how these sites are created. For example, tenant always on first level, region always on second level, site always on third level, or whatever. And then it would be useful to automatically define those context without having to put a sling config ref property on each of those 1,000 sites and updating it if the site gets moved, etc. And for this, is an SPI exists. You can define your own context pass strategies. And to make it easier to do it only in a declarative way, our WCMI project also provides some extensions with some ready-to-use context pass strategies. And I will show them to you. Example, for example, one is the absolute parent context pass strategy. With this, it's possible, for example, like I just for the talk I just mentioned, having tenant, region, site, and you configure via OSGI to set, okay, my context paths always start at absolute parent level 1 and 3. In this example, the red-lined pages are the starting points for your configuration context, meaning you have one context for each tenant and one for each site. And for some reason, I left out the region. Of course, you can include it as well if you just say 1, 2, and 3, or whatever. And if you have fixed structure of your content, you can just use this strategy, and you do not have to define any sling config ref attributes properties. You can still do it. You can combine it, but by default, you would just leave them out, and your context is automatically defined. And you can define different configuration for each site, for each tenant. You can inherit configuration from tenant to site, etc. Another alternative is using the root template context path strategy. If you have not a fixed convention that your site always starts at level 2 or 3 or whatever, but it can start at any level, but you have a fixed template, for example, your site's always using a specific homepage template or one of a list of homepage templates. You can use this strategy, and wherever this homepage template is detected in the parent hierarchy, the strategy knows, oh, there is a new configuration context starting. This is the root of my site, so this is the innermost configuration scope. And you can define what happens with the parent pages. You can define that these are automatically detected as parent nested configuration scopes, or you can filter the sites here as well. You can do it via configuration. So this is very useful if you have a lot of sites in your AIM instance to automatically define the context path. And this is an example, how do you define which structure is used below the conf folder. In this example, I'm just using regexp to filter the content path, and this group is used to identify a variable part I want to use. I put it here below the conf path, and then I just use the same structure from content to conf, which is mapped. You can do, of course, more complex regex and more complex building of path patterns, so you have quite freedom to define how your structure below conf is looking like or how it's derived from the content path. Another addition, AIM-specific addition to CA-config is using specific persistence strategies. I already mentioned that by default, CA-config in AIM can read SQL page notes below /conf, but it cannot write. This is just missing currently in AIM-63. And so if you write configuration, it's using the default link implementation, but just using unstructured nodes below conf. And WCMO extensions for CA-config provide an alternative persistence strategy, which allows you to store it in exactly the same way as, for example, used by AIM conf manager and used by default AIM below the conf folder. And you just have to enable it if it's deployed, and then it has a higher ranking than the default persistence strategy and stores all configuration using typical couple of SQL page and SQL page content nodes of a JSR content node and stores the configuration just within this JSR content node. And then it's a bit easier to publish the configuration. Another option we added primarily for backward compatibility for the old configuration support we had in WCMO, but it may be usable for other use cases as well. You can choose to store the configuration not below /conf, but inside your content tree. For example, in a folder tools config. This has some advantages. For example, it's easier to package the configuration together with your content because you have only one path and not a lot of paths. And the configuration can be easily activated together with the other content from the author environment by just activating the editor page, which also contains, in this case, the configuration values. It has some disadvantages, but as well, it's not so easy to protect your configuration because it's just below content, which is usually open from the outside. This is easier with the separate conf folder to manage your ACLs, and it's not the best solution because it somehow mixes content and configuration, which was one of the main motivations to introduce conf, to have a clear separation between content configuration. But yes, if you want to use it, you can use it if you want to make use of these advantages. And another features I wanted to hint at is using override providers. I already mentioned last year that they exist, but now I have two examples where they may be useful. Take the following use cases. You're using CA-config, for example, for externalizing ULs in your site. That means for each site, you have defined perhaps two or three domains, perhaps your domain name, perhaps a secure domain name if you switch from HTTP to HTTPS, and perhaps more. And if you're using this, it's all working well on production. But now think about you want to package all your production content to your test system and want to test it as well. And in this case, you do no longer want to use the production domains, but perhaps use one or a couple of test domains. And if you do not want to always rewrite all the configuration on your test system, which is specific like this domains, it would be useful to overwrite just the site URLs and keep all other configuration like it's on the production system. Or another example, if you have, for example, a feature flag which enables or disables specific features on your website, like a special car configurator, for example. You have some markets which use a car configurator, some markets would have it not. Then you have 500 sites having this flag enabled and 500 other sites having this flag disabled. And now you have a problem with your latest deployment of car configurator. You want to switch it off everywhere, but only, for example, for 2 hours until this problem is fixed. Then you need the possibility to just quickly override this flag in all sites, and if the problem is fixed, restore it back to the previous state with having 500 ones enabled and 500 not enabled. And for this, you can use the override providers. An example, you have different ways to define those override via OSGI configuration or via command line parameters. The recommended way is using OSGI configuration. So if you just activate in configuration with an override provider, and you can add lines like this, multiple lines. In this case, I'm overwriting the whole set of parameters from whatever package, my config configuration name, configuration class. And I say, OK, overwrite all parameters and use only this one, site URL, like my test domain. If this gets active, then all sites on my test system, for example, are using this domain and not the domain which was initially placed in the production configuration. Or another example with the feature flag. In this case, for example, I would only override for tenant one, for all sites below content tenant one, this class, and only one property, not all, but only one property. Then I just say, OK, this car configurator flag on my config is false everywhere for sites below content tenant one. And once the problem is fixed, I just remove this configuration again, and then the initial configuration, which will be stored in the conf folder, gets active again. Yeah, so this may be very useful for certain use cases like this. Yes, and I assume you're all writing very good unit test coverage for all your Slink models and AAM code. And if this code is using CA config, config-aware configuration, then we have some support for this as well. If you're using AMOX or Slink MOX, if you're only doing the Slink part, then you have available two plugins, which you can plug in your AMOC or Slink MOC context to automatically set up a MOC version of this context-aware configuration. So this is an example of the dependency declaration in your Maven POM, having AMOC or Slink MOC as main dependency, and then this for the Slink part. This is published from Slink MOC for CA config. And if you're using AMOX, you can also add this plugin, which adds support for this WCMA CA config extensions in your code. And with this, it's quite easy to use it. You have a slightly different syntax to initialize your context for unit tests with a JUnit rule. You are using a builder, AM context or Slink context builder, and you are adding the plugins. In this case, the Slink plugin and the WCMO plugin if you're using extensions, and then you are ready. And if you are now using your code for testing, then you can access all CA config specific features. You can, it's presented because it's constructed of perhaps 5 to 10 different services, OSGI services need to in the mock and some configuration. And all this is set up automatically by the plugin, and you can just use it right away in your code. And it has also some utility methods, for example, registering your classes of your current project, your configuration classes describing the configuration. The mock can automatically detect these for references. So if a reference library which contains such declaration, it detects them automatically. But at least in Eclipse, I'm not sure about other IDEs, this is not working for classes in your current project. And then you can register it here. And here's an example. If you do not want to provide OSGI configuration for your context path strategies, there are some helper methods to just set up a simple context path strategy, which might even another from your normal prediction usage just for unit tests to, so the code can look up the configuration where you put it in your unit test. So it can be, for example, tested with different configuration values read from CA config from the conf folders. Yes, conclusion. So if you are using AM and the context-aware configuration and the different extensions from WCMO we have shown today, like the editor and the extensions, then you can successfully use all these points. The only one that is still missing is a simple option to activate the configuration. You still have to use, if it's stored below the /conf folders, AM packages, or other means, you have no button in the GUI, but we are thinking about adding it to the configuration editor as well, so this gets easier for the authors and editors to use. Yes, and if you want to use it in your deployment, the WCMO extensions, you just have to add two bundles or whatever you need. For example, only the editor, only the extensions, or both of them. They are not dependent on each other. And then it's available in your application. You have to define your own configuration editor template deriving from the page component. So you can define where it can be created and which icon and description it's using. Or you just use for convenience this IAM package, which includes this editor bundle and a default implementation of this template, so you can use it right away. Yeah, some references, the documentation from WCMO site. We have some training material online as well, open sourced for the WCMO extensions of context-aware configuration. And if you want to contribute something like adding more special widgets for editing, then you're welcome. There are the entry points listed. And the demo projects I've used here is online as well. You can just deploy it to your AM 6.1, 6.2.3 instance and try it out for yourself. And of course, we have documentation on the Slink side of the basic stuff and this talk from last year. Yes, this was.
So, any questions? Okay, here in the
phone.
Go on.
Hey, I know we had a conversation by mail about it, but you talked about the ability to activate configurations, but there would be another one from AEM, would be MSM and translation, things like that. And for that reason, I was attempting to put configurations and their contents, yeah. So that I have everything, yeah. Which brings its package of annoyances. But yeah, I would like to know your point on mm-hmm. that. What do you think about it?
Yeah, configuration should be lower at /conf, but to really enforce it in project, it should be easy for the editors to really activate it from there, and then we have the complete picture. Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Any other questions? So everyone is just hoping and expecting the lunch break. Okay, for now, thank you, Stefan, for your presentation.